Hi, everybody. It's time to live, love, and laugh with Joey Sudica. Now, here's Joey! Started how long I've been in the business. Actually, I was 8 years old when I was playing over at a place called Newark at the Mosque Theater. Anybody ever hear that? And I was playing with an old accordion band. We were on the Ted Mack Amateur Hour when I was about 10 or 11 years old with a 50-piece accordion band. Do anybody remember Ted Mack? Oh, good, you're almost as old as I am. All right, that's pretty good. And actually, my first paid career, or where I started, was a place called the Meadow View Inn. Bet you never heard of that. Yeah, I know, it's because it's located in Belford next to a fish factory. And it was on a New Year's Eve in 1960 that I actually played with a group called the Starliners. There was a saxophone, guitar, drum, and myself on the accordion at that time because the pianos were in such rough shape. And I'll never forget, we made, I believe I got promised for 5 hours, $10 for the night. You remember, we had those days, I'll tell you, $10 for the night, and then we stayed another extra hour, and I think they gave us, they passed the hat, we collected $1 or $1.25 each. And the next day, the sax man, who was the leader, was knocking on my door. He says, Joey, you gotta buy this fake book now of 1,000 songs. It's $16. So I was already in a hole. As I said, I'm happy to be here. I'm happy for a lot of things. Number one, my daughter moved out. Those of you who were here last year know exactly what I'm talking about. They moved in, lock, stock, and barrel. My daughter, my son-in-law, and the two kids. At that time, one was about 5 years old, and the other one was about 8 months old. Oh, man. And they only were going to stay a couple of weeks, and they almost stayed a couple of years. Oh, God. Okay, but you missed the little kids. Do we have any grandparents? You don't want them to move in for a year, though, do you? My little grandson, I related this story, I probably told you, but he was sitting on my lap one day at the house, and I love the kid. He says, they call me Pappy. He says, Pappy, you're getting old. So, I guess it beats the alternative, but I didn't know how to tell that to the kid either. So I, you know, just smiled like this at him, and I didn't know how to take it. But the following week, he was sitting on the other grandfather's lap, and he says, Grandpa, when are you going to die? I'm just getting old. The other guy, he's... They say the craziest things, though. I get the biggest kick out of kids in my life. I was teaching a Sunday school class about a month ago, and asking the kids, I says, if I put all my money in the collection basket, will that get me to heaven? And there are about 15 kids in the class. No! I says, well, if I clean the floors and sweep the floors in the church and everything, will I get to heaven? And they said, no, no. I says, well, how can I get to heaven? And one kid raises his hand. He says, you've got to be dead. Question? They keep reminding you about this, you know? It's like the little kid that went into his grandfather. This one worries me. Grandpa, can you make a sound like a frog? Grandfather says, no, why? He says, because Daddy says, when you croak, we're all going to Disney World.
When you're smiling, you're smiling. Gonna smile with you. Hey, when you're laughing, and when you're laughing, that sun is gonna shine on you. Ah, but when you're crying, now you bring on the rain, so stop that sighing. Come on, be happy, happy again. Just keep on smiling, cause when you're smiling, that whole world smiles with you. One more time, just keep on smiling. Keep on smiling. Yeah, the whole world. you're laughing, when you're laughing, that sun is gonna shine on through. Ah, but when you're crying, now you bring on the rain. So stop that sighing, honey. Come on, be happy, happy again. Just keep on smiling, 'cause when you're smiling, that whole